Hi, welcome to the Create Space. In the field trip Storytelling and Art, we explored a variety of ways that artists incorporate stories into their artwork, and also some ways that we might be inspired to create our own stories from works of art. Another thing that artists sometimes do is create books that are their artwork. These are often called artist books. Artist books can look similar to books that you've seen or read, or they can look really different. Some might only have drawings or pictures. Others might have words or a combination of drawings and words. And some might not even look like books. They might look a little bit more like sculptures or even kind of abstract. In this activity, I'd like to show you how you can make your own book, like this one, from just one piece of paper. But first, let's explore some examples in the St. Louis Art Museum to see some ways that artists have created their own books.
This book is titled Led Almost by My Tie. It comes with a yellow, plastic, bucket-like object that can also be attached to a wall and used as a shelf to hold the book. Here are a few images from inside the book. The book includes a variety of materials and techniques, including poetry, artwork, a collection of different papers, and even pieces of plastic. What materials, pictures, or words would you want to include in your artist book? Here is another book titled Ziggurat. This type of book is called a pop-up book. It looks like a book when it is closed, but when you open it, there are paper shapes that pop like sculpture. What shapes do you recognize as you look at images from this book? In this book, titled Woodcuts by Antonio Frasconi, the artist uses only images. Let's scroll through a few pages from the book. What do you notice as you look at the illustrations in the book? What are some ways that you would like to tell your story?
Now that we've seen some examples of artist books, let's go ahead and make our own. I'm going to show you how you can take a piece of paper like this one and fold it into a book like this. And then you can add lots of different things. You could draw in it, you could write in it. This one has kind of a surprise as you keep going. There's the head. You could glue different things into it. You can cut it into shapes. You can really make it yours however you want to. I gathered a few materials, a couple that you'll need to make the book, and then some others that are optional that you might want if you want to decorate in different ways. Feel free, if you need to pause the video to go and gather materials. So what we'll need is a piece of paper to make your book out of. I chose to make mine blue, but it could be any color that you want. And there's lots of different types of paper that would work. You could do construction paper. You could take paper from a notebook or a printer paper, or you could even try something recycled like newspaper or a magazine page. You just want something that can bend pretty easily and fold, so not super stiff. And then you'll just need a pair of scissors. So those are really the only two things that we'll need. You might also want some other items if you want to decorate in different ways. You could have colored pencils or markers or crayons or paints if you want to add some color, draw some pictures. You could have some different colors of paper if you want to glue elements in. You might want to have glue if you want to glue some different things in. So I'm going to move these out of the picture so that we can focus on the folding. But I just wanted to share those with you. And I'm going to keep the scissors and the Sharpie because I'll need those. So if you have your paper ready, you can go ahead and fold along with me. I like to have my paper so that the short edge is facing me and the long edge is facing up. And the first thing that we're going to do is take one side, the long side, and fold it in half in a hot dog fold. And I like to try to line up my corners so that I get a nice edge here. And it helps my pages to be kind of even when I finish. And then you can take your finger and you can crease it on that part where it's folded to make your first fold. And then you can open it up and you see you have a line. And I'm going to go ahead and turn it. And I think that makes it a little easier to fold. And then we can fold it in half again. And I believe that is a hamburger fold. And try to line up those corners. And then take your finger and smooth it out to make that fold or crease. And now it already is starting to look like a book. So you can open it. It's kind of like pages. And then you'll see, so we have two intersecting lines. We have one that goes vertically and one that goes horizontally. So we can take our page and we can fold one side in half to meet this middle line. So I'm going to take my edge and I'm going to fold it just part of the way so that my edge meets that line in the middle. And then crease it just like we did before. And then I can do the same thing on the other side so that they meet in the middle, kind of like a high five. And then now it almost looks like doors that you can open. So we can open it back up and then fold it back in half the way we had it before. And so now you'll see you have four boxes and two lines, one that goes vertically and one that goes horizontally. So I'm gonna draw, we're gonna do a little bit of cutting now, and I'm gonna draw the line that we're gonna cut, but you don't need to draw yours. This is just to make it easy to see on the video. So I'm gonna start on the side that's folded and then draw a line right to the point where these two lines meet in the middle. And this is the place that we're gonna cut. So you're gonna cut, you're gonna start on the side that's folded, and then you're gonna stop where your horizontal and your vertical line intersect or meet in the middle. So you can take your scissors, and then I'm gonna cut and stop halfway where the two lines meet. And then you can unfold it, and it's kind of almost like a mouth, like, and you'll notice that your page wants to naturally fold in half. So we're gonna follow that fold. And then you can see if you hold your two edges that you can almost play it like an accordion and it has this diamond shape in the middle. So you can take it, hold your two edges and push it in the middle of that diamond so it comes together. And then I like to hold it and I like to put it on the table and then it will kind of naturally fold together. And so you can crease along that line in the middle and fold your pages in. And there you have a book. And then you can, now you're able to open it, turn the pages. You also, it's kind of fun, you could open it all the way up, draw a picture in the middle, and have kind of a secret picture, and then fold it back up into a book. So now that you have a book, there's lots of fun ways that you can decorate it to make it your own. As I mentioned, we looked at this one where there's a drawing. This one I collaborated with a friend and they drew the dragon and I colored it in. It doesn't have any words in that one, just pictures. This one I put a title on it and thought it would be fun to use some construction paper. So you could do something a little mixed media. You could combine drawing with pictures, with paper or collage. I thought it would be fun to add in some secret elements. So I have these windows and you open it up and there's a donut inside. Or as you turn, there's this door here and you can open the door and there's a robot. Or you could play around with adding text in different ways. You could write, and this one I wrote some prompts. I'm gonna hide this robot. I wrote some prompts for myself to do later, like write a short story, hide something for someone to find. So you could create a pocket and have something that can come in or out of the pocket. You might wanna, I thought it'd be fun to glue some items that I found. I have some more kind of prompts for myself, or you could even have a pop-up element. So this one is attached just with kind of an accordion paper that I folded. So that's just construction paper. So now that we have a book, I'll show you two simple ways you can make a pocket and a door. And then you can experiment with coming up with your own things that you could make or try. So I have some paper here that I have used for different projects, but I still have plenty of paper left. So rather than using a whole new sheet, I'm gonna try to use up some of this paper so I don't waste it. So I think I'll start first with the pocket and I'm gonna cut just a rectangle shape. And you just wanna make sure it fits into your book. But you don't have to, you can make it as big or as small as you want. And then I'm gonna start and I'm gonna fold one of the long sides. And you can decide, I'm not gonna fold it too much, it's less than half. I just want kind of a small fold. And then I'm gonna turn it and do the same thing on one of the short sides. And I'm just folding right on top of that long fold that's already there. And then I'm gonna turn it and do the same thing on the other side. So it's a little bit like a U. And we have three folds. And then the front side is going to be your pocket. And these tabs are what you glue into your book. So I'm going to find my glue. And then I want to glue just the edges of these three tabs that I folded. But I want to keep the inside part clean so that my pocket can expand. So I'm going to glue one of these short sides, and I'm holding it up so you can see it, but you could put yours on the table too. And then I think I'll glue my other short side. And then I can glue the long side. So I did just kind of the folds that make the U. And then I'm going to find a place in my book that I want to put my pocket, and I can squish it in and smooth it out a little bit. And then I'll need to let that dry a little bit before I kind of open it, or I might pull it off. But then you'll see you have this space right here where you could put different things. And you can experiment with, maybe you could make a bigger pocket, or you could make it come out more, or you can try out lots of different things. And then to do a door, I'm gonna do a pretty simple one where it's just a rectangle and a pretty small one. But you could make yours lots of different shapes, lots of different sizes. It's really up to you how you want to do it. So I just cut another rectangle and then I folded it. I'm just going to fold it in half and put some glue on it. And again, it could be lots of different shapes and sizes. And then I'm going to find another place. So I have this page open. I think I'll put my door here. And I think just for fun, I'm going to draw mine to look a little bit more like a door. So I'm going to put a doorknob on it. And I think I'll put a window. And then I could come in later if I wanted to put something inside the door, like a picture, or glue something in. But maybe you don't want yours to look like a door. Maybe it could be something totally different, like a bookshelf or whatever your mind can come up with. So those are just two ways to make a door and a pocket.
Thanks for joining me in the Create Space. Now that you've made a book like this, I encourage you to see what else you can create. Try out some new ideas, experiment, have fun, and make lots of books. Thanks. Bye.